Queen of Heaven, rejoice, alleluia. For he who merits to bear, alleluia, has risen as he said, alleluia. Pray for us to God, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I welcome you to Mass. Because of the Ascension, praise God, is back on its proper day. Today we keep the seventh Sunday of Easter in year C. And we offer our Mass to repose the soul of Edna Heron. Eternal rest come to her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, pray for the needs of the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in excelsis Deo. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray.
Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Saviour of the human race is with you in your glory may experience, as he promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
He fell asleep. speaking to me. Very soon now, I shall be with you again, bringing the reward to be given to every man according to what he deserves. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Happy are those who will have washed their robes clean, so that they will have the right to feed on the tree of life and can come through the gates into the city. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to make these revelations to you for the sake of the churches. I am David's vine, the root of David, and the bright star of the morning. The Spirit and the bride say, come. Let everyone who listens answer, come. Then let all who are thirsty come, all who want it may have the water of life and have it free. The one who guarantees these revelations repeats his promise, I shall indeed be with you soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Holy Father, I pray not only for these, but for those also who through their words will believe in me. May they all be one. Father, may they be one in us, as you are in me, and I am in you, so that the world may believe it was you who sent me. I have given them the glory you gave to me, that they may be one as we are. With me in them and you in me, may they be so completely one that the world will realize that it was you who sent me, and that I have loved them as much as you love me. Father, I want those you have given me to be with me where I am, so that they may always see the glory you have given me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Father, righteous one, the world has not known you, but I have known you, and these have known that you have sent me. I have made your name known to them, and will continue to make it known, so that the love with which you love me may be in them, and so that I may be in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
those who suffer for Jesus Christ enjoy the glory of the Trinity. This truth is seen in Stephen's martyrdom, as he is granted the mercy of the Trinity's presence, even while still on earth, before laying down his life for the truth of Christ and his gospel. Today, Christians are still offered the crown of martyrdom, and it takes great courage to accept it. It is not simply an acceptance of death. No, in fact, we have already accepted death in holy baptism and risen with Christ to new life. It is instead a martyrdom of acceptance that Christ must increase and we must decrease. It is a humility that treasures Christ's teachings as handed on by the apostles and in turn by the church. Even when the world promotes an ideology contrary to truth and virtue. Truth and virtue are behaviours that are eloquent. They are an effective way to preach the gospel. It is our mission. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. An important martyrdom is that we also unite our passions to the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may pass over with him from death into life. And the supreme test of love is agape, that when we are called upon, we place the other, that's the needs of God, the needs of his church, the needs of his holy people, ahead of our own personal desires. Stephen's trial, you can even call it that, is an illegal lynching. And actually such behaviour is truly alive if you ever subscribe to social media. As they say, never read the comments. That's where you'll find a lynching. And those who stand up for the truth are often subject to ad hominem attacks on the person or character rather than any intelligent debate on the issue. You always know you've won the argument when someone starts to attack you personally. St. John in the Apocalypse shows how God wants people to understand his revelation. Because all of us need to be consoled and strengthened for the trial to come, that being our personal judgment with God at the end of our life. Blessed are those, however, who have washed their robes clean in the blood of the Lamb and have brought their baptismal garment unstained into the kingdom of heaven. And if you're wondering where your baptismal garment is now, don't think about a piece of white cloth. Think about your soul. Our regular confession is important because in a very real way, it anticipates this personal judgment. It restores us to the mercy of divine life that was first given to us in holy baptism. All of us make up the church and we are the bride of Christ. In fact, the Christian life is an RSVP to a wedding. The betrothal has already taken place. It took place on the cross. Now Christ the bridegroom has returned to heaven to prepare a place for us in his Father's house. And like you remember the parable of the wise virgins, we are awaiting the return of the bridegroom. We're ensuring that our lamps have plenty of oil in them. That oil is our faith. And our faith, while personal, is also corporate, as we belong to that body of Christ, the church. When the bridegroom returns, there will be a great banquet. It's a victory celebration of the Lamb of God, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. So all of this next week, we are praying afresh for the coming of the Spirit at Pentecost. At 7 p.m. each evening, there is the novena to the Holy Spirit. We thank Gislaine, who is organising it and leading it. We're praying, it's part of that preparation for Pentecost, for unity. And that unity stems from the unity of the Trinity. Hence why the celebration of Trinity follows the week after Pentecost. It would be a complete nonsense to say that we are Catholic in union with the Church, while at the same time rejecting Christ's teachings in either word or deed. And so this Sunday, which the bishops have designated World Communications Day, our Catholic media also have a responsibility to provide us with an authentic commentary on the Church. As a journalist once said to me in Crawley when I was there, he said, yes, the problem is, Father, as journalists, we don't let the truth get in the way of a good story. It's important, though, that we know our scriptures and our catechisms, so that when we're opening the newspaper, when we go online for our news, when we watch the biased broadcasting corporation, sorry, the BBC, the British Broadcasting Corporation, that we're able to know the credibility of the news and evaluate it properly. The Church's divine mission lasts to the end of time. And so while the Church might slowly move in terms of finding new media to broadcast the Gospel and the Mass over the internet, the truth of the Gospel, the truth of the faith, it remains eternal. It's beneficial to every generation to come. The Church, of course, existed before Pentecost. It's found firstly in the Holy Family. It's found then in the calling of the Twelve. It's already receiving its nourishment from Christ's word and from the blood and water that comes from its piercing side. But it is at Pentecost that the Church becomes apostolic. We go from here. We're charged to bring the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. So we should be really excited that Pentecost is now just around the corner. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, the one who guarantees these revelations repeats his promise. I shall indeed be with you very soon, and so we pray.
For the Apostolic Church, pray for the renewal of the Holy Spirit. May all members have the courage to go out and announce the good news. Lord, in your mercy. For Catholic media around the world, may the message they convey reflect the gospel and tradition of the Church. Lord, in your mercy. For our diocese, call to mission, especially to our family and friends. May they know the love and compassion of this community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may the Lord Jesus receive their spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We now ask Our Lady of Rosary to pray for us and with us as we say.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
In a moment of silence, we pray for our own needs.
Almighty Father, in this celebration of Holy Mass, we can see heaven thrown open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. And so we ask you to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, for my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Lift up our
hearts. We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples, and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with possible joy, every land, every people, exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
For the mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servants Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always." Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, may you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Saviour, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ our Head, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
So the second collection is for the World Catholic Communication Network on this World Communication Sunday. The box is by the first collection box, which is at the junction of the exit with St. Anthony. On Monday at 3 p.m, there's the SBPT at 3 p.m. There's no 10 o'clock mass on Monday because I've got a hospital appointment. And Father Rogers, of course, it's his day off and he's still on holiday. The SBP pilgrimage to Aylesford, to the Shrine of Our Lady. There's still a few spaces left if you want to go. Please look at the newsletter. And at the front here, there should be a basket if you want to place any intentions for the SBP pilgrimage to take place at Our Lady's Shrine. There's a few, a limited number of newsletters in the porch intended for those who do not have access to the internet, because if you've got the internet, you can read the newsletter online. I'm trying to save paper, we're trying to save money. Don't forget that if you are coming to Mass next Saturday evening, Pentecost Vigil is celebrated in its extended form as a mirror of the Easter Vigil. It's still at 6 p.m. but it has the extra readings and psalms, and there will be a choir. So bear that in mind if you need to plan taxis or lifts, because Mass will obviously be a little longer. And all weekend, Masses next week, we'll pray for Her Majesty the Queen. We'll also pray for her at the Mass on Friday this week. And you can see there's just a little subtle hint that we're doing Mass in the middle of the church. Nice little fit photo of Her Majesty, so you can pray for her now and all week. As I said, Gislaine will be here at 7 to the